17th of January 2019, Thursday. This is a female, not spayed, 12 years old Shih Tzu.
Okay. Now, this Shih Tzu came in with a complaint of vaginal discharge, right?
Not eating.
Yeah. Not due to discharge. So the complaint was the dog was not eating. When the dog was not eating, normally it's sick. At this time, was there any discharge? That was 2 days ago, right?
Yes. I think the nurse discovered there's some discharge.
Yeah. Because you can see that this part is sticky. Very sticky, that means there's some discharge. In fact, there is still discharge that you can see there.
Yeah.
There's some discharge. Despite antibiotics. So, normally when there's a discharge here from the vagina, it's called open pyometra. That means there is infection of the womb, the birth tube. And normally this is the disease of old dogs, female dogs. They have not been sterilized when they were young. Now, because when they grow older, the uterus becomes poorer in the immune system. You cannot fight against bacteria. So the bacteria goes into the uterus from the cervix and also from the dogs, licking her private parts when she has periods, when she has hits. Do you see the dog licking the private parts? When was the last hit? Normally they will clean up, they try to clean up so the bacteria goes into here. Yeah. When was the last one?
The last heat.
Even though the dog is so old, 12 years old, they don't really go into menopause in the sense like humans. So it still comes on cycling. Now, how many days was it? The heat, November, which is about 2 months ago.
About 2 weeks.
Fresh blood? Red blood?
Initially, yes.
Initially red blood, after that it becomes a brownish.
Yeah.
So that is a sign that the uterus is infected. And at that time, pyometra has not come yet. Pyometra means infection of the uterus with the pus coming out. It comes only 2 months later, which is correct, because now it's January, right? Yeah. It's about 2 months. Now, so you came 3 days ago, right? About 5 days.
Saturday.
So she came about nearly 5 days ago, and the dog was detected with discharge here and given antibiotics. So the dog actually on antibiotics for 5 days. Now, normally it's quite okay to do operation, but because the condition of the dog is very thin, you can see that. It's really bone, you can see that. So it's considered thin. Now, I will just take the temperature again, because the temperature was 37.5. Now, normally the temperature should be 38.5 minimum. So 37.5 definitely is low. Now, when you operate on a dog with low temperature or high temperature, they might die from being not well. They are not well yet, you see. Not fit for surgery. It's 37.7. So 37.7 is not ready for, that means it's cold. It's not good for surgery, so I wouldn't advise it. But if you want to do, then you have to take the risk that the dog might just die or can't recover from the operation. Now, first of all, I will do a quick check. So the first check is body condition score. Body condition score refers to the condition of the body. Now you can see from here. Now this dog will be under 2. Come this side. 2 upon 9. 2 upon 9 means quite too thin. Normally the best is 4 upon 9. Now too thin, you can see that there are certain conditions. Just to check, what's the 2 upon 9? So 2 upon 9, you can see the vertebra. You can see, of course it's covered by hair, but you can see it. It's easily seen from here until the hip. So then also the blood test was done. Blood test was done earlier. And the important thing was this dog is anemic. Now anemic means doesn't have enough red blood cells and hemoglobin. So, and it's very low, you can see that. The hemoglobin, which carries oxygen for the dog, is normally should be 12, the lowest, but it's 9.1. Then the red blood cell, which should be 5.5 at least, is 4.1. So these two already show that the dog is anemic. That means you shouldn't operate on an anemic dog and try to let her recover first. And this takes about a month or two of good food, iron supplements, vitamin B's. Then once this goes back to at least 12 and 5.5, then the dog is actually healthy and fit for surgery. Now, surgery is to remove the infected worm. Then we look at the total white cell count. Now, total white cell count is a bit high because normally maximum is 17, but this is about 19, so it's high. And then the neutrophil. Neutrophil is the bacteria fighting white blood cells. Now it's really 92 or 93%. Now normally it's only 60 to 70%. So definitely there is a bacteria infection in the blood at that time when it was taken last Saturday. Now you look at the absolute number of neutrophils. Absolute means the total number. Now you can see it's about 17 or 18. 18. Now normally it's up to 11.2, maximum 3 to 11.2. So anyway, this one will tell us it's high. So these two are high, so this dog definitely has bacterial infection and anemia. And also you see the platelets is low. If the platelets are a bit low, that means the dog is toxic, the blood is toxic due to the bacterial infection. Other than that, the dog is okay. You can see that the liver is all right. That okay, this one. Bone function all right, I would say. And then the kidney is okay, although the urea is high. Glucose is okay, so no diabetes. Kidney, I would say okay, although the creatinine is a bit low. No, creatinine is okay, actually. So overall, the dog has anemia and blood infection. So today, the best is to give another drip and the vitamin Bs. And then you of course, continue the antibiotics. Yeah. Mm. You have how long?
Last visit is Sunday or something.
Yeah. So about 14, yeah, on the 14th. Yeah. Never mind. So anyway, the body temperature is a good indicator whether the dog can go surgery or not. So if the body temperature is below normal, don't operate.
Okay.
Because if it dies, then we also feel very sad. And then we didn't advise you. You see, so now we advise you, but it's up to you. You want to take the risk?
No, then we will just...
Okay, I'll just check the heart. I have a quick look at the membrane. Should be pale.
Yeah, pale.
Pale, right? Still pale.
Mm.
Okay. I see. Mm. It's really whitish. It should be pink. And then you operate, you'll be very safe. I'll check the heart first. Heart is okay. 12 years old, this dog has a right. Check the lungs. Lungs, no harsh sounds. No rapid respiration. So the lungs is okay. That is good. So I do the abdominal palpation as part of the physical examination to check what any lungs are in the abdomen. So use the four fingers and my thumb. So I palpate the front first, the stomach, liver, spleen. See any lump or not? There's a bit of pain. You can see the dog. You feel a bit of pain. So it's not. It's very weak. So not much pain, but there's a slight pain. So the there's a bit lump there. Has it passed urine?
Yes.
Sometimes it's due to the. This could be due to the uterus. The uterus being full of pus. So it's still charging, discharging. So this one, in this case, can feel a big lump. And this lump is most likely, because it's on the posterior part and the lower part of the abdomen, this is the uterus. Uterus is swollen. It's swollen about 3 centimeters across. That means normal uterus is only about 5 millimeters or less. So and then couple, turn upside down, see? Turn upside down. And we check from here, they definitely come in and see there's still some discharge, but not so much because of the antibiotics. So the dog is still eating or not eating?
No, not eating.
Still not eating. So not eating, you give another drip, and not eating at all, zero.
Zero.
So that means the infection is still there, the bacteria and also the anemia is still there. So it's best to give another drip, and then we'll see. Once a dog eats, then it is at least on the way to recovery, and possible to do already.
Okay.
Because this type of cases is really unfit for surgery, anesthesia. So I don't want cases where the dog survives the operation but died 1 or 2 days later due to the body being too weak to withstand the anesthesia and surgery, because this surgery still takes half an hour, no matter how fast you can do.
Okay.
You can only say like 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, then I would say go ahead, maybe 2 minutes only or less. And then it needs the drugs also, and the sedation, anesthesia. So don't rush into it. Because 12 years old, once after they operate, then they are better, they can still live up to 15. Because the heart and kidney are, the heart, liver and kidney are okay, you see. No,
okay.
No coughing, right?
No.
Yeah, only that this eye is blind, right? Dry eye, this is
dry
the dry
eyes.
This one, also dry.
Dry.
You can see really anemia.
Yeah.
Okay, I know, just have a quick look. I want to see your teeth. See your teeth. Teeth are so bad, but that one can be done later. This one should come back to normal first. So we will do the treatment first. Okay, Judy, finish.
Okay.